Partner in the plan. Partner. Jesus was given to you, and with the help of those who don't know the law, you put him to death by nailing him to a cross. But this was God's plan, which he had made long ago. He knew this would happen. God raised Jesus from the dead and set him free from the pain of death, because death could not hold him. Acts 2:23-24. The cross was no accident. Jesus' death was not the result of a panicking cosmological engineer. The cross wasn't a tragic surprise. Calvary was not a knee-jerk response to a world plummeting toward destruction. The cross wasn't a patch-up job or a stopgap measure. The death of the Son of God was anything but an unexpected peril. No, it was part of an incredible plan, a calculated choice. The moment the forbidden fruit touched the lips of Eve, the shadow of the cross appeared on the horizon. And between that moment and the moment the man with the mallet placed a spike against the wrist of God, a master plan was fulfilled. What does that mean? It means Jesus planned his own sacrifice. It means Jesus intentionally planted the tree from which his cross would be carved. It means he willingly placed the iron ore in the heart of the earth from which the nails would be cast. It means he voluntarily placed his Judas in the womb of a woman. It means Christ was the one who set in motion the political machinery that would send Pilate to Jerusalem. And it also means he didn't have to do it, but he did. It was no accident. Would that it had been. Even the cruelest of criminals is spared the agony of having his death sentence read to him before his life even begins. But Jesus was born crucified. Whenever he became conscious of who he was, he also became conscious of what he had to do. The cross-shaped shadow could always be seen. The screams of hell's imprisoned could always be heard. This explains the glint of determination on his face as he turned to go to Jerusalem for the last time. He was on his death march, Luke 9:51. This explains the resoluteness in the words. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own accord. John 10:17-18. The cross explains why John the Baptist introduced Jesus to the crowds as the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. John 1:29. Maybe it's why he tore the grass out by the roots at Gethsemane. He knew the hell he'd endure for saying, "Thy will be done." Maybe the cross was why he so loved children. They represented the very thing he would have to give. Life. The ropes used to tie his hands and the soldiers used to lead him to the cross were unnecessary. They were incidental. Had they not been there, had there been no trial, no pilot, and no crowd, the very same crucifixion would have occurred. Had Jesus been forced to nail himself to the cross, he would have done it. For it was not the soldiers who killed him, nor the screams of the mob. It was his devotion to us. So call it what you wish, an act of grace, a plan of redemption, a martyr's sacrifice. But whatever you call it, don't call it an accident. It was anything but that.